Hey everyone, so today I'm going to give you the glimpse on mathematics behind the barcode numbers. And especially I'm going to talk about ISBN numbers and the UPC numbers. What are ISBN numbers? ISBN numbers are nothing but they are the barcode numbers which you find behind the book. So if you take any book and you will see a barcode over here and this numbers, it will be a, if you count this, it will be a 13 digit numbers. So ISBN, that's what is called as many times ISBN 13. And if you take any old book, you will see that there will be a 10 numbers behind the barcode. So those are ISBN 10, and the latest one you will see ISBN 13 numbers. And ISBN stands for International Standard Book Number. Okay, and what are UPC? They are nothing but the Universal Product Code. And in India, usually you will find they are 13 digit in number. Okay, so they are 13 in number. So these are the codes which you usually find on the products which you buy from any grocery store or any general store. So if you have any product next to you right now, you can just pick up that product. If it has a barcode, you just count, it will have 13 digits. Okay, so I'm going to talk about these two special numbers today and how these are calculated and how one should check whether the barcode number are valid or invalid. And we will see that a very simple, the basic mathematics which you see in your high school, that can be applied over here to check the validity of the barcode numbers. Okay, but that I'm going to tell you at the end. So for this talk, you need to be a bit patient because I need to build something about the barcode numbers so as to you will realize the importance of mathematics behind these numbers. Okay, so let's sit back and enjoy the talk. Okay, so what are barcode numbers? So barcode number has played, no doubt it has played a very important role in everyone's life, especially to the trader's life or the one who do businesses. Like suppose if I'm a businessman and suppose if I want to order say 50,000 jeans and suppose say 10,000 of one brand, 20,000 of another brand and remaining 10,000 of another brand. So I have this stock with me. So if I want to do the stocking of these jeans, will I keep on counting each and every jeans? No, right? I won't be counting each and every product. I will have the barcode numbers of these jeans. And in the software, I will see how many are left. Because how do I sell them? I simply scan the product. And once it is scanned, that will be removed from the software. So, because of these barcode numbers, checking the stock of the product has become very easy. So, it helps us in checking the stock. Secondly, suppose if I observe, okay, so these are type A jeans, whose demand has been increased drastically in the market. And if I want to increase the price of the jeans from say 2000 to 3000 rupees, so what will I do? Will I take out each and every jeans and if I will change the sticker? No, right? I have their barcode numbers in the system. I will enter the barcode number and I will change the price to 3000 rupees. And if I observe, suppose it's a type B jeans whose demand is very less, I'm not able to sell it. So again, in the software, I will just decrease the price by simply entering the barcode numbers, so that when the scanner will scan that barcode number, okay, so for this barcode number, this much is the price, and yeah, you're done. So it helps us, it really saves our time. Okay, no need to do individually on each and every product. So these are the plus points of having a barcode on the stickers. But then obviously when there are some plus points, there are some negative points as well. Instead of saying negative points, I would say there are chances of errors. When we do all this process, there are chances of errors. And usually if you have studied computer science course or computer engineering, you might have seen this. But let me give you the brief idea about these errors. So these are the six types of errors usually one see when they deal with the barcode thing. So the first one is called as a single digit error. The name itself suggests, but let me elaborate a bit. So what are single digit error? So suppose if I say to my colleague, okay, enter the barcode number 3179, and instead of 1, he will just type it out 3279. So there is an error in single digit. So that's why this is called as a single digit error. Or even once the barcode are generated, we do the printing. And while printing, it might happen that it was supposed to enter 9, but then this line got miscarried. So it becomes 3. So this, there can be many reasons because of which there might be an error in a single digit, and therefore such kind of errors are called as a single digit errors. Second is called as a transposition errors. The name itself suggests just transpose. Like suppose the barcode number has to be 3127 and it has happened 3217. So numbers have been interchanged. So such are called the transposition errors. The next one is jump transpositions. Like there is a jump in between. So like suppose the barcode number is 123, but this was the barcode number, but mistakenly it has came out to be 321. There is a jump in between and there is a transposition of the digits. So therefore jump transposition. What are twin errors? Like suppose the barcode number is 31147. So instead of 11 it has become 32247. Like instead of 11, by mistake 22 came into picture. So these are called as twin errors. What are jump twin errors? Again the same thing. There is a jump. Suppose the barcode number is 171 something, but instead of 171 it came out to be 272. So there is a jump in between, and therefore it's called as a jump twin errors. And the last one, nothing but the phonetic errors. Now what are phonetic errors? Like suppose if I'm saying my colleague that okay, you enter 2630. So 26 instead of 13, you might have heard 30. So and some other. So these are called as a phonetic errors. So, while listening, there might be some, or while seeing, something might come out and something wrong come out, and because of this, instead of 13, 30 came into picture. So these are called as a phonetic errors. But then if you see the Google and run Google and if you see the analysis, top two errors, they account for around 88 to 90% of the times. And if you see rest four, they hardly occur for the 10% of the times. In which this occurs around 0.7% of the times and all. But yeah, so these two are, they are the major errors. So these two occurs very frequently, 88 to 90% of the time. So whenever we try to make an algorithm, we should make sure that our algorithm should detect these errors. If they can't detect these errors, then our algorithm is of no use. Okay, so how do you check the validity of a barcode number? So this is the ISBN 13 number, is the barcode number of a book. I just wrote down over here. So if you can count, there are 13 digits. Now how do you check the validity of the barcode? Like, I mean, if a scanner will scan this barcode, like how will the scanner know whether I should give a green light or a red light? Red light means it's an error, green light means okay, it can go ahead. Right? So how does the scanner also decide whether this is a correct barcode or not, whether this is a single digit error or not, whether there is a transposition error or not? So how does they determine? For that, last digit plays a very important role for the validity of a barcode number. And this last digit is called as the check digit. I mean, for any good numbers to get, ISBN numbers, UPC, IMEI number, the unique number for each and every phone, or say bank account numbers, credit card numbers, debit card numbers, you take any such numbers, last digit is always called as a check digit, and this check digit is not related with the product. Like suppose this is a number of a book, like say first will represent the country of origin, then rest six will represent about the distributor or the printing thing, rest five will represent about the the author and all those things, or something like that, some combination. But the last one is not related with the product, it depends on the previous, in this case, previous 12 digits. If you have ISBN 10, then the last digit will depend on previous 9 digits. Okay, now, so whenever a scanner will scan a barcode number, he will take these 12 numbers. With the help of an algorithm, it will arrive at a check digit. Then the check digit which the scanner will scan, and this check digit should be same. If the both terms are to be same, okay, green light will come, you go for the next product. If the red light is coming, that means there has been some error. Okay, so now how one should calculate a check digit? So the algorithm I'm going to talk about is 1-3 algorithm. So very simple algorithm. So what is 1-3 algorithm? You do 1 times the first digit plus 3 times the second digit. So what I do is, you do this calculation, 1 times the first, 3 times the second, 1 times the third, 3 times the fourth. So what I'm doing, the numbers which are at the odd places, I'm simply adding them, I'm simply multiplying by 1. So I'm simply adding the digits which are at the odd places, and the digits which are at the even places, even positions, I'm multiplying them by 3. So the one which are at the even positions, I have simply multiplied them by 3, and that's what is called as the 1-3 problem. This 1 and 3, these are called as the weights. Actually, see, if you simply add this number, it is called as a sum. But if you multiply these numbers by some other numbers, then this sum is called as a weighted sum. This is a very common terminology, but yeah. So this is a weighted sum. If I do the calculations, let's see what I will get. So if I do this addition, it will come out to be 115. Now what is the check digit? Check digit is a number such that if you add to that number, so check digit, how this is calculated? This is the number so that when you add to this weighted sum, your answer should be a multiple of 10. It should be multiple of 10, or in the language of number theory, or to be specific, in the language of modular arithmetic, this should be congruent to 0 modulo 10. Or in a simple language, you should add a number over here such that this sum becomes a multiple of 10. So obviously it's 115. So what is a single digit? Single digit I will add, so then it becomes a multiple of 10. Obviously I will add 5 over here, so that the addition will become 120, and 120 is a multiple of 10. As you can see over here, the check digit is 5. So that's how the check digit is calculated. You simply add the numbers which are at the odd position, and the one which are at the even position, you add them up and multiply by 3. You get a number, you get a weighted sum, and you add a check digit, or you add a number such that the total sum will be 0 modulo 10 or multiple of 10, or the remainder should be 0 when you divide by 10. And this is how a check digit is calculated. And this is called as a 1-3 algorithm. Now one can ask, why 1-3, why not 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, or why not 2-3, 2-3, or why not 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, right? There can be plenty of combinations. Instead of 1-2, why we are choosing 1-3? See, as I told you previously, single digit errors and transposition error, they constitute around 90% of the times. So our algorithm should detect those errors. That means if there is a single digit error, then the scanner should be able to detect. And if you, for that you need to write a proof. Obviously you can't be doing with each and every number. You need to write a proof. And in the proof, we are using a fact that the weights which we are multiplying, like the 1-3, the weights should be co-prime to 10. That means their GCD with 10 should be 1. Because, I mean, when you see the proof, those are interested, I will post a link in the description, so that you can see the proof of this thing. Okay, so this, your weights should be co-prime to this, only then that error will be detected. Like if you take 1 and 2, then 2 is not co-prime to 10. Then there are chances that even though the barcode is invalid, the scanner will scan and it will give you the green light. But that should not happen because it's an invalid barcode number, right? And the same thing works for a UPC code. What are UPC? Universal product code. Like if you take any product from the grocery or the general store, again it will have a 13 digit. For that also the same 1-3 algorithm will work. So like if you have a book or any product near to you, just pick it up. If it has a barcode number, 13 digit barcode number, you try to put this algorithm, you will observe, I mean, and try to find the check digit. The check digit which you are getting, and this should match. Okay, so that's just a fun exercise which I would suggest you to do. So that's one thing. I also told you about ISBN 10. Now, because suppose if you have some old book like 90s or 2000 book, then or older than that, you will see that there will be a 10 digit barcode number, ISBN 10. Or if you publish a book paper in a journal, you will see there are two ISBNs, ISBN 10 and ISBN 13. Now, suppose if you have a 10 digit number, say X1, X2, X3, up to X10. So this is your ISBN 10. Now, again here also, so you will see that the last number will be called as the check digit. And how that is calculated is, what you do is, you do 10 times the first digit, plus 9 times the second digit, plus 8 times the third digit, plus 3 times the 8 digit, plus 2 times the 9 digit. Okay, so do this 10 times the first, 9 times the second, 8 times the third, up to 2 times the 9th digit. You do this weighted sum, your last number, which is nothing but the check digit, which is nothing but my X10. The last number should be such that this whole thing should be congruent to 0 mod 11. Or in a simple language, it should be multiple of 11. And you do this weighted sum, this last number you should add in such a way that this becomes a 0 modulo 11. That means it should be a multiple of 11. And now here, what are the weights? The weights are 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. And if you observe, all are this are co-prime to 11 because the 11 is a prime number. So all the numbers less than 11 has to be co-prime to, or the their GCD or HCF with 11 is 1. So all these things you are seeing in your high school, like prime numbers, GCD, HCF. So as you can see, this basic school, basic mathematics which you learn plays a very crucial role in doing such big businesses. So all these weights are co-prime to 11, and therefore this algorithm will also detect all single digit errors, and it will detect all, what I'm saying, all transposition errors. So this is how the mathematics is used to determine the validity of the barcode numbers. If you, I mean, this algorithm is not true for bank account numbers or the credit or the debit card numbers. For them, there are different algorithms, and obviously they are a bit tricky. Maybe in future I will discuss those as well. But I hope this you found useful. Only my suggestion is to take any book right now or any product, and you can calculate this barcode number. One more thing, it also helps you to calculate any missing number, right? If you have, suppose, 273, one number got missed away. These are 13 digit numbers. Obviously, this is a check digit. And the question is, what is this number? It might happen that because of some whatever. I mean, this number might get vanished. I mean, it gets crashed away, or something might happen and this number got missed away. This algorithm also helps you to calculate this missing digits. Okay, so that's why it's a very strong algorithm, both 11 as well as the 10. So, yeah, so that's the importance of mathematics. I hope you like this video. Have a nice day.